Hello there, and welcome back to another installment of SCP Readings, with your reader here, Gmodon. Today we're looking at SCP-236. There is a link down in the description for you to follow along as I read out loud. SCP-236 appears to be a swarm of near-microscopic crabs. Individuals match no known form of crustacean, and elements of their physiology appear to point to an artificial origin. SCP-236 appears to operate under a form of a collective intelligence, or hive mind. This intelligence appears to grow when individual SCP-236 are in close proximity, and dissipate when they are divided. Large swarms appear to exhibit predatory intelligence, and become significantly more aggressive than individuals. Swarms show aptitude with problem-solving, encircling tactics, and stealth. In addition, swarms appear able to take on the physical aspects and appearance of inanimate objects, such as doors, chairs, or even complex patterns such as those found in paintings, for extended periods of time. This mimicry is near perfect under casual observation and requires detailed observation to detect. Swarms will sometimes even destroy existing objects and replace them in what appears to be an attempt at better disguise. SCP-236 can create additional individuals from any organic matter. This includes wood, cotton, or other materials derived from an organic source. SCP-236 units appear to remove small portions of matter with their pincers, consume it, then lay small spherical eggs, which hatch into new members after 10 minutes. Juvenile SCP-236 look identical to adults, but are smaller in size, and lack the chemicals used in the defensive response. Juveniles reach full adult size after 6 hours. SCP-236 individuals appear to fear light, rapid movement, or loud noises. This fear is reduced in proportion to the number of units in a swarm, but even large collectives can be startled by a sudden sound or bright light. SCP-236 that are startled while mimicking an object will rapidly break apart into individual units, which will then scatter and hide. Swarm regrouping can take up to 24 hours. When cornered or unable to escape quickly, SCP-236 units will initiate their defensive response. This entails a unit raising its pincers and then detonating with an explosion equivalent of 9.07 kilograms or 20 pounds of C4 explosive. Initial research suggests that this is the result of an internal chemical reaction involving the mixing of 3 normally inert chemicals. Collection of these chemicals has been problematic due to the relatively minute size of the storage chambers and the likelihood of startling SCP-236 during the procedure. SCP-236 will use humans or any other living things as a resource, provided the swarm is of a sufficient size. Moderate swarms can convert a whole human being in less than 5 minutes. Individual SCP-236 have also been observed entering the human body, typically while the subject is asleep, and begin to consume it from the inside out. This behavior, coupled with the mimicry and the defensive response, make SCP-236 very difficult to detect and contain effectively. Addendum. While SCP-236 has not been observed to mimic organic life, the possibility exists for SCP-236 to develop this behavior, notably during testing on data expunged. Such formations are to be immediately reported, and testing area cleared immediately. You know, to me, these kind of SCPs are kind of what freak me out a bit, because hive mind, you know, type things like ants or bees or anything, those things just, ugh, I can't stand them. They just gross me out so much. And the thought of these guys being able to mimic and blend into pretty much anything that's made out of organic substance, it's like you find a chair somewhere and you're like, oh, it looks like a nice chair. I'm gonna sit down in that chair. You sit in it and you get consumed by all these little crab things. And it's so gross and it's just, ugh, it gives me the heebie-jeebies. But the good thing is, they have a weakness. They're afraid of really bright light, and they're afraid of really sudden sound. But just the thought of one of them entering into your body while you're asleep and eating you from the inside out, hatching eggs inside of you, and the entire thing just, it just doesn't sit right with me. And it's so sad, too. I find crabs cute. But after this, not so much. That has been SCP-236. Thank you for joining me on this reading. Like, comment, subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next one.